Hi children, a very good morning to you. So far I had discussed with you about basic concepts, what are the adjustments are there, everything I have discussed with you in the previous classes. Today I am going to discuss with you about admission of a partner. Before moving to admission of a partner, first of all you have to understand what is meant by reconstitution. It's nothing but, look at the meaning, any change in the existing agreement. Here existing agreement is called partnership deed. That deed will come to an end and a new agreement between the partners comes into force. It's nothing but either admission or retirement or death of a partner, the old agreement will come to an end and a new agreement between the partners will exist and the business will continue for a long period. So it is known as reconstitution. We can expect this reconstitution meaning in one more question. Okay, next, which are the modes are there for reconstitution of a business? Let's see. First is admission of a partner. It's nothing but there may be two or more partners as old partners. If they admit a new partner for getting any additional capital or for expansion of the business, they may admit a new partner. So in this way, a old agreement between the partners will come to an end and a new agreement between the partners will be existing. Next, change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Here there won't be any admission or retirement or death of a partner. Partners, they themselves will change their profit sharing ratio. So here there will be a reconstitution of a business and business will also continue for a longer period. Next, retirement of a partner. For any reason, any partner may retire with the consent of other partners from the business. So in such a case, business will continue and their profit sharing ratio will be changed in a new form. Next, death of a partner. In this case also, for any reason or insolvency or anything, a partner may die from the business. So the old partners or the continuing partners will continue the business. It will not be stopped. Next, amalgamation of partnership form. There may be two or more partnership business may be amalgamated or joined together. That time their profit sharing ratio and other details, everything will be changed in your form. And business will continue, it will not be stopped. So these are the modes of reconstitution of a partnership firm. Next, we'll go to the admission, the main topic. Admission, look at the meaning. When a firm requires any additional capital or for the expansion of its business, a new partner may be admitted to the supplement of its existing partners. It's nothing but, children, there may be a partners already they've started the business and for any additional capital or managerial help required from a person, they may admit a new person as a partner and it will be very useful for them to expand their business also. Okay. Now look at the definition. According to section 31 subsection 1 of the Indian Partnership Act 1932, a person can be admitted as a new partner only with the consent of all the existing partners unless otherwise agreed upon. It means a new partner can be admitted only with the consent of existing partners. So old partners have to give their consent and they have to agree to appoint a new partner. If they don't agree, a new person cannot be appointed. Okay, that is the definition. Next, at the time of admission of a new partner, what are the rights to be acquired by a new partner? Let's see one by one. First right is to share the future profits of the firm. He has the right to share the future profits after the appointment. Next is right to share the assets of the firm. He has a right to share the assets after his admission. So the first two rights are very important, which may be asked repeatedly in one mark question. Okay. Next, third right is right to participate in the affairs of the business. After his admission, he has a right to participate during the meetings. Next, right to inspect the books of accounts. He can verify the books of accounts and how it is maintained, what are the procedure to be followed, everything he can understand after his admission. Next, right to take decision in consultation with the existing partners. Whenever a firm taking any decision, he can participate as well as he can take decisions also in consultation with the old partner. So these are the main rights to be acquired by a new partner at the time of admission. Next, adjustments required at the time of admission of a partner. So in the basic concepts lesson, we have so many adjustments. That adjustments also will be applied in the admission lesson also. And at the time of admission of a new partner, what are the main adjustments are there? If you understand these 5 adjustments, it will be useful for preparing 8-mark question. Okay, let's go one by one. And in each heading, we have subtopics also. Okay, first adjustment is calculation of new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. How to calculate sacrificing ratio and how to calculate new profit sharing ratio? We have formulas. Let's see after one by one. Next, second topic is valuation and accounting treatment of goodwill. How goodwill is valued and what are the methods to be adopted for calculating goodwill? And what is accounting treatment of goodwill at the time of admission of a partner? Let's see one by one. Next, revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities. It's nothing but at the time of admission of a partner, the assets and liabilities are to be revalued and reassessed. And the profit or loss arising from that will be distributed to old partners. There are so many adjustments under this topic. Let's see later. Next, distribution of accumulated profits and losses. Old partners may earn profit or they incurred loss also. That should be distributed to old partners. So let's see later. Next, adjustment of partners' capital. At the time of admission of a new partner, a partners may wish to change their capital into different value. So what are the adjustments are there? Let's see later. So these 5 adjustments you have to understand clearly. Okay, let's see the first adjustment, calculation of new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. So how to calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio we have to understand. First, I let you the meaning of new profit sharing ratio. It's simply known as NPSR also. The ratio in which all the partners share their profits and losses is known as new profit sharing ratio. It means after the admission of a new partner, the old partners also may wish to change their old ratio into new ratio. So that time new ratio can be calculated. Formula to calculate new profit sharing ratio equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Okay. Next, how to calculate sacrificing ratio? First, see the meaning. The ratio in which the old partners have agreed to sacrifice their share of profit towards a new partner is known as sacrificing ratio. So at the time of admission of a new partner, old partners have to sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner. So that time new sacrificing ratio must be calculated. See the formula. Sacrificing ratio equal to old ratio minus new ratio. Okay. Next, to calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio, we have different cases that should be understood by you. First is equal sacrifice. It means if there are 2 partners, both partners have to sacrifice equally. So how to calculate new profit sharing ratio? Let's see. Next, unequal sacrifice. If they unequally sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner, how to do the problem? Let's see. Next, entire sacrifice by only one partner. It means if there are 2 partners, only one partner will sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner. So how to calculate? Let's see with the problems. Next, when sacrifice unknown. In the question, there won't be any sacrifice given. So how to calculate sacrifice for the old partners? Let's see. Next, surrender value. Both the partners, if there are 2 partners, both the partners will sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner. So that time how to calculate new profit sharing ratio we'll see. Okay, with the example problems. Let's see the first case, equal sacrifice. If there are 2 partners and if they are equally sacrificing towards new partner, so how to calculate new profit sharing ratio? Let's see with the problem. There are 2 steps to calculate new profit sharing ratio. In that, step 1 is acquired share equal to new partner share into number of existing partners. If there are 2 existing partners, we have to multiply into 1/2. If there are 3 partners, we can multiply into 1/3 with the new partner share in the step 1. Next, in step 2, new profit sharing ratio we have to calculate. For that, formula is old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Okay, look at the problem. I explain you. A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 7:3. They admitted C for 1/5 share, which he acquires equally from A and B. Calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio of the old partners. Here A and B are the old partners. Their profit sharing ratio is 7:3 and they admitted C as a new partner for 1/5 share and C is acquiring equally from A and B.
So here there are two partners, so we have to multiply into 1/2, 1/2. Got it? Next, see the answer. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Heading we have to write. Then A, B, C I have written with the space. Next, old ratio. Their old ratio for A and B is 7/10 and 3/10. And acquired share of C we have to calculate. For the formula is new partner share into number of existing partners. So new partner share is 1/5, 1/5 for both of them. And the number of existing partners, here there are two partners, so we have to multiply into 1/2, 1/2. Is it clear? Next, we have to multiply to get the sacrificing share. So 1/5 into 1/2, if you multiply, it will be 1/10. And 1/5, 1/5, if you multiply, you'll get again 1/10 for B. So A and B, both the partners, they are equally sacrificing 1/10 share towards C. Next, new profit sharing ratio. Formula is old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Now we have to deduct sacrificing share from new old partners old share. So for A, its whole share is 7/10 and he has sacrificed 1/10. So we have to deduct 7/10 minus 1/10. It will be 6/10. For B, his old share is 3/10 and we have to deduct 1/10. So B's new share will be 2/10. And new partner's new share is 1/5. So to make it denominator equal, we can multiply into 2/2. So C also will get 2/10. So their new profit sharing ratio will be 6:2, 2:2, or 3:1:1. So in this way, we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio under the first case, equal sacrifice. Next, how to calculate sacrificing ratio? Here only the old partner sacrificed equally. So their equal ratio is 1/10, 1/10. So sacrificing ratio also 1:1. So for the other cases, we'll see in the next class. Thank you.